Welcome from our Mettler Toledo Application Lab in Switzerland. In this video, I will show you how to determine the color of a sample with our UV-Vis Excellence spectrophotometers. I will demonstrate this analysis with a color determination of a battery electrolyte. As decomposition progresses, the color of the electrolyte turns yellowish. Therefore, we will measure the yellowness index of the electrolyte. This parameter can be used for quality control purposes as the degree of decomposition reflects the water content within the sample. Let's start with the method configuration. To create a new method, click Methods and select Scanning. All predefined color calculations are located in Scanning, even if no full spectrum is required for the color calculation. By clicking New, the method configuration is started. To unlock color calculations, you have to activate color. For scan-based color scales, you can select between various illuminance and observers. Most of the time, however, illuminance C and observer 2° are used and do not need to be changed. By confirming the input, the method editor is shown with predefined method functions. Under Spectrum Evaluation, you can select the unit of the measured spectrum and some further post-processing options like smoothing and peak finding. As the yellowness index is based on the transmittance spectrum, we change the unit to %T. To calculate the color number, you have to add the method function calculation by clicking Insert. The calculation can only be added after spectrum evaluation. Now we can define the name, yellowness index. As a unit for the yellowness index, we can define yi. Where can you find the correct formula? By clicking on Formula, you can input a formula. Color calculations are predefined. You should navigate to the number keyboard on the top right and click C for color. Here, you can find the list of all predefined color calculations. All the calculations are defined for a path length of 10 mm. You can select the desired color scale from this list, in this case, yellowness index. The correct formula is automatically inserted. Additionally, you can define the number of decimals, for example, 2. Some color calculations are also predefined under result proposals. In this case, the method function is automatically filled. The operator can define an upper and lower limit for the result for quality control. It is important to mention that you can add as many calculations as you want. So, with only one method, you can determine, for example, several color scales or get other information, like absorbance at a specific wavelength. You simply insert another calculation method function for this purpose. Last, you can define how the results should be displayed on the screen. As we have only defined one result, we define one result field and select R1 yellowness index from the results list. Now, we can save the method and are ready to start the method by clicking Start. You now have the possibility to save the method to your home screen with Add to Home. This will create a shortcut on the home screen and is highly recommended for frequently used methods, as they can be started with one click. For this, you have to define a name, for example, YI electrolyte. By saving it, you will end up on the home screen. Just click the shortcut to return to the same screen as before. Now, you can define the sample ID and change the dilution and correction factor if needed. Clicking Start a second time will guide you through the workflow. First, we have to insert the blank cuvette. By clicking OK, the blank determination starts. Afterwards, we are asked to insert the sample cuvette. Again, the measurement is started by clicking OK. The measured transmission spectrum is shown on the screen. With the button Calculated Results, you can switch between the spectrum and the calculated results, which is in this case the yellowness index of your sample. I hope the short video was helpful understanding how to set up a color measurement with our UVVS Excellence spectrophotometers. This analysis can also be automated with our cuvette changer for up to 8 samples or for up to 303 samples with our InMotion autosampler. Check out our automation webinar or our automation guide here. Thank you for watching this video, and don't miss our other videos explaining more measurement categories and how to get predefined methods from our application library on empty.com.